Seven was in wood. You know, from Brother Rashadi. First, I want to acknowledge you, the English, your leadership, our leadership, all the English, all of you, men and women of God, for being here today. Greatly, greatly appreciated.
Allowing us
time. Today is a Tuesday. You have a lot of work to do. You know, the same man, share my support.
Government
is committed to many critical things that build a nation. Not destroying a nation, but building a nation in its integrity. All the different facets. Joseph, we as a government, I want to say to you publicly, we're committed to fostering areas, aspects, components that will allow this country to advance, that will allow, enable this country to move from the bottom to there where it should be. It's a lovely country. God gave us a lovely country. God loved us so much. Sometimes I even ask myself, Michelle, I'm in Zambia, do they appreciate how much God loved us? By just giving us this country, for example. It's the first point, starting point, to appreciate this asset God gave us. I'm coming from Qatar. Just maybe a week ago, or less. When you see a country, a small country like Qatar, that's the way to pronounce it, which has sand, dust, hardly any fresh water. I'm a stranger, Shabuno, like it was raining tonight, this past night. No reception. I am Kafir, I am Zambezi, I am Indian Ocean. We don't appreciate these assets for us. They are that country from oil and gas only has delivered value for its people. And you can see it. You look left, right, front, back, you can see it. Leadership. Leadership is crucial. We want to acquire this. We must place a premium on leadership in whatever way. Business, government. For a long time we say government, so. No, crucial. Church, you know, leadership in the church is crucial. You think to build a church like this is being lucky? No. It's organization. Of course, everything best with God's help. Leadership, yes, in the environment of God's help. God's hand. It's always there. That hand is there for everyone.
Amen.
It's there. But on top of that, it's a leadership. It's order, it's organization. So I want to say to you, this government is committed to providing the leadership, the orderliness that led us to the bottom. Lack of orderliness which led us to the bottom. I'm letting you know, I'm just stating things there. And then we consciously agree that we have to do something different in order to take this country there, where God designed it to be. So we will work hard. We will work very hard. Because God's grace comes along when you work hard as well. And God has his hand. I encourage all of us to work hard. I already talked about skills, education, even our diversity of skills. You want me to jump up more? Yeah. But you want mission. I know that segments of our society believe that a country can progress without hard work. I disagree with that. I totally disagree with it. The things you've talked about, They require ingenuity. They require skill. They require hard work. These things we talked about here. So let us drive this country in the direction of hard work, but also honest. Honest. These are important values. Christian values. I dare say. Honest. Respecting public property. You say, if we pay, you are if we pay. They must be used to work for the owners, the citizens. And I say that to my colleagues in public office. When we appoint colleagues in cabinet, PSs, DCs, I always say to these colleagues, set your souls first. Are you willing to respect that boundary? That this is public property, this is private. What is public must be used to save the public. So that we can answer this question to you right here. As a connection, is it a point? The connection you're in. And I say these things, my bishops, my pastors, to drive a point and to make a contextual understanding so that we don't confuse ourselves. When you hear us fighting against corruption, the reason we are fighting against corruption is to make sure that we draw that distinction and use the public assets to deliver free education, to deliver meal allowances, to deliver desks for our children in schools. That's the connection we're making here. To manage resources in the most efficient, optimal manner, so we can deliver products. I'll say a few things about that. This is the beauty of an interaction like this. Hey, Akalin, my little friend, in this hour, we will be church in this Adventisti. No, we must not hear. No, we shall hear. My wife used to say, is there another HHI? Yes. HHI is an important. But please, I know. We have been married to you for a long time. I have not seen those things people talk. She's now interrogating me. Maybe I have a split personality. So I would answer, I said, very question. But look at God's grace that today we can interact and share these views direct, live, openly. We listen to you say things, you pray for us, you sing for us. Choir, please, before we close, yeah, that song of mine, eh? I beg to break the program before we close. That's a song that you opened with. It must be the one we close with. So look at God's grace that He can allow us to sit in this manner with bishops like Him that has seen it all. Why not that one? Just so they know who I'm talking about. You can wave at people. For us to feed from His wisdom and from all of your wisdom. This is how God works. So we can separate facts from innuendos, mysteries, competitive talk, and sometimes falsehoods. That's why I talked about honest. Falsehood. Why can church today left 3-4 pages of lies against the bishop here, who you know has not done anything right. This is what our country has become. We must work together to say no to those things. At a youth endeavor 2 days ago in Lusaka and the youth celebrations, we were. I said to the youth of Zambia, "Imiti kula, number going bad offering." Social media, we won't feel we know. Not the way it's being used now to generate falsehoods that can create hatred in society. It is money. So I return to my theme. God allows us to interact in this way, to share issues about what our country must be. There's nothing that beats God's way. His ways are not our ways are not
His ways.
God is good
all the time.
And all the time
God is good.
Because that's His nature.
Yes.
So, the things I've said is to buttress, to provide an overarching understanding of what this new government is intending to do, is to develop this country. In all respects, difficult as it is, our agenda is to develop this country. Do not hear another agenda than what we've given you. Is to develop this country. Education, health, infrastructure. I know you talk about roads. But the water harvest infrastructure, look at this water. You are the providers of a lot of the water in this country, from this region, Northern Ridge, Copperbelt, Northern, Northwestern, Wapula. Wapula is taking the water into Lake Tanganyika, no Congo. Congo and there. Most of the water that this country gets down south comes from Copperbelt, this country, comes from Northwestern, but the assets that sit in Wapula, Northern Muchinga, great assets. For which part of the infrastructure the government is focusing on is energy. We talked about load shedding. Energy. Green energy. In that northern corridor. But we must maximize the energy capacity we have already. So water harvest is very important. The government is looking at those issues. Clean water, sanitation for our people. For our people to be healthy. Growing the economy is number one for us. Growing the economy is our greatest, single, most important thing we are focusing on. Because when we grow the economy, agriculture, energy, all of those, we then can provide for our population.
Amen.
That is how. There has been a distortion in our country to focus on consumption without production. Is that possible? If we don't produce, how are we going to consume? To focus on jobs without investment. Is that possible? To focus on sharing without creating. Number 12 plus the share for what? I'm serious. It's a paradox. It's a paradox, a paradigm as well. Paradox and a paradigm. That's a shift we need. I think I've said enough around the generalities. But the economy, growth will allow us to support the community, the weak, the sick, the old, the young, the differently abled. Supporting God's work, churches. I'm old fashioned myself, I take notes. from here, we go back to set as we sit down, we say, how we deal with that item, how about that item, which ministry deals with that item. That's the way my mind is framed. So, if that is agreed, that the economy is number one, then it can support us in all our different needs, then let's make sure that we drive that economy. We work together. The church is integral to this. Very, very good. Very, very good. Just imagine a Zambia without you, a church. Just imagine. Think of 1989, 90. Assume there was no church in this country. How could we have gravitated into multipartism without a church? Just imagine. So, do you see how important you are as a church? Think of the church, which is not there, was not there, towards 2021. Think of the church not being there towards the first 1991, I said, 2001, in 2021. Think of it. It's rough. So you are cardinal. The message I'm sending, the house of God is cardinal to all of what I'm saying. Let me say one or two things around. I know Bishop Tashila mentioned it. And I'm learning every day. I'm a perpetual student myself. I learn every day. I want to encourage everybody to be a perpetual student, to learn. Every day when you interact with people, there's something you can learn. You can learn. Is to say, Bishop Pajina was saying to me in the office, repeat the things we've been saying already. Don't assume people have heard. Just repeat. And I'm here to repeat that. This country, as President FTJ Chiluba declared, shall remain the Christian country. Yes.
Yeah, sure.
See now. But the body of Christ is one. Different churches in our Christian nation. Thank you. That's my repeat song today. What is my other repeat song? That in this country, we decided as a people of this country, through our constitutional provisions and other laws. So laws bind us together. Tell you. Because leaving you without the laws, look at how many we are here. This one, that group will be doing something else. That group will be doing another thing. That group will be doing something contrary to what that group and that group is doing. Eventually, you fight. So we make laws to bind us towards a common behavior, common interest. This country has decided long time ago, and it shall be going forward. We as a population, we as a political party, we or parties, we as individuals, including myself, we do not support gay and lesbian.
That this country must be reunited.
all of us. From all the 10 provinces, we are one Zambia,
one nation,
one people. Let's repeat that. One Zambia,
one nation, one people.
That's it. On the platform of unity, we shall accelerate development. I return to the case of development as a focal point of our conversation. On the platform of, remember, honesty, hard work, all those things. Talked about agriculture, talked about energy, talked about mines, we talked about. It is all on anchored on a trajectory of growth, development, economic development for social support. That's my phraseology now. Economic development for social support. Because certain sectors, you can't run them commercially by. They need to be supported. Because they're inherently, it's difficult to run them commercially by. So unity in our country. We should not allow divisive behavior. We should not allow violence in our country. We should not allow pointing a finger at each other. Look at this Copperbelt. It's a melting pot. Look at this Copperbelt. Bien, ah oui, voyez, ils ont maintenant pas fait une vision. Bien, bien. Then when we can't is united on that platform, we can deliver economic development for social support. We have a economic development for social support. It's not commercially viable for government to put desks, clinics everywhere, maternity wing everywhere. That must be supported by a viable site, which is economic. But we need units. Divisions must not be allowed to come from ethnicity. I don't know anyone here who chose to be what you are. We say, Mali, I want to use the proper term. Were you there when your parents loved each other? Yes. You were not there. So how could you make a choice? I'm sorry for expressing it that way. But it's the truth. Were you there to have made a choice? We are all created in the image of who?
God.
Now, if we are a Christian nation, how is it that we discriminate each other?
Mm.
That is anti-godly.
Yeah.
So, if you hear someone pushing that card, you must know that you are a member. This is not God's teaching. Fim, so, I leave you with that assignment. Copperbelt and the pledge. Preach to us politicians. Look at the UPND government. It's deliberately selected to send a message that this UPND government belongs to all the 10 provinces of Zambia. Deliberately. Anyway, those are the broader issues I wanted to raise today. Taken not to belabor the point, we shall address these issues in an organized way. And submissions, I guess, have been made, like last time. Submissions have been made. But if you haven't made your submission, please, beautiful submission, make sure that you hand them over through the church organization that you are already working with here. And then the government accesses those. But I want to send a message to my cabinet and PS Bakason, lay over. And we call up this is, I can say this is here, MPs, councillors, this president here, your servant, I'm your servant. Some things don't require the president to remind us what our colleagues said here. We can address some of the things immediately. Immediately. That's why we sought public office, to be servants of the people. I'm very touched with issues around land. I know what the land is doing to me and the family. I know that I've been able to send my children to school by raising cattle on the land. I know that I've been able to build shelter by raising and grazing cattle. Me, I was laughing inside. Christmas, New Year Christmas. I got some customers here who came to buy boots from my place. Two of them. How are you? Chipoka. So the way that they folk take a shiny. Just to give you a hint, 1 week between Christmas and New Year, I took time off. 1 week I took time off, I sold about 300 boots. This retirement money before I even retire, this retirement money.
So when people say that, ah, but you know, they don't take it. I said, what are you talking about? I want to teach them, share with them. When they discover that act, you never leave it. It's addictive. Takes care of you, takes care of young people, and I'm encouraging young people. Go for me. We'll support you. That's why you've seen the CEC programs now advertising for different businesses there, including farming, dairy, beef, bricklaying, everything. Don't be forced to do what you don't like. Do what you like. That's how business works. Do what you like. When your love is there, the rest, God's help, the rest works. So I am saying there are things we can address. Like yesterday, whoever won Fever and Nandi. That's correct, isn't it?
Yes.
We fellow workers working for the people. Roads, land, I stick with the land. Land is very important. I think the councils, local government minister, let me go back, when we go back, we pick up this issue. In cabinet. Most of these things will find their way in cabinet. I want people to tell you. For individuals, for the church, there is never a society that has no social component. There's a commercial component. That was the message being given.
Yes.
To acquire that. Then the cost of the fraud, application, application processes and all of that. Let's not be shy, even corruption inside on the issues of land. What we want is legal land. We don't want illegalities. Please, in the apartment, eh? Because that's where we lose it. Legal land. So we'll take up that, including growth for the chair. I'm happy you acknowledge that duties are well. If there are other duties that are still there on church requirements, please, in this organized way, like I said, submit that list. So we can look at it. The infrastructure point we've had, let me share with you. We found no money in the treasury. And we couldn't do the roads, even the roads that our friends bought on the understanding that they'll do the roads. And since this used to be their strong one, we expected beautiful roads here. But they're not there. Now the treasury is empty. We had to find an ingenious one, a clever way of doing the roads. Public-private partnership, where we are funding the roads at a lower cost, without sacrificing quality, but also timely delivery. You already noted the pentagon road. It was being done and then ripping off at the bottom. Thank you. Thank you. I have asked the colleagues to go ahead to Mingula. From here we're going to Mingula. So the infrastructure, the roads, we had to find an ingenious way of doing them, which includes the triple P, having private partnership. And hence the Chingola, Chilila, Bongwe, Kasumarisa. At a fairer price, quality, and indeed timely delivery. But Lusaka 327 kilometers. And now we said no, we have no money in the treasury. With interest, that road was going to cost $1.8 billion. Now $1.8 billion. Before, when we came in, we said we can't do that. Cancel that contract. We've now let the contract, men and women on board, at around $600 million, less than half the price. But no direct government funding. We don't know indirect financial institutions, NAPSA, yes. That debate we're having in the country is not the right debate. It should not even be there. That is mischief. And
It will be done in 3 to 6 months. We will have 3 gangs working, so that is done quickly. Different portions of the world. No sovereign guarantee. Those of you who understand finances know what I'm saying. No sovereign guarantee. Nothing. Not a penny from the taxpayer direct. That's ingenious. No one thought we'll do that fraud before we resolve the debt crisis. There we are. Now we are working on it. Dollar Mufrila. We are working on border posts, Sakana, Mokambo, to decongest these trucks. I'm very unhappy. I'm really irritated when I come here and see those trucks. I'm angry inside, but I don't show it. That's how God made me. But inside, I'm burning. We can't have business slowed down like this. Unfortunately, we have to deal with our colleagues on the other side of the world. And we're patient. We keep on meeting them. I'm meeting my colleague. We were together just 10, 15 days ago. I said, my brother, what's going on? But we'll continue. But things within our control, we work on. And those include now building properly. Sakania, Mokambo, of course, that's what I said. Keep pushing into Somalia. We're working on, some of you don't know your country, but Ishimbe, help me, Lume, to take us to our border. I will be announcing very soon the programs that we are concluding by June on that corridor. And you'll be very happy. All of them without using taxpayers' money. So we can use the taxpayers' money to deal with some of the things you're saying. Some roads, we can't do them on that basis. We will have to use taxpayers' money. It's a combination. I commented to people with the property. Chadiz and Chipata Road cannot be done on a PPP, but we are going to do it. I'm just going to that. So, a number of the things you've said here will address them properly. CDM, this year is the year we are unlocking rigidities. CDF has been increased, but we want it to be easily accessible by you. Yes, this is the year of reforms. Let me remind you, CDF belongs to the communities. The churches are part of the community. You must draw on that CDF. You are the men and women of God. If you run a school, why should you apply for an additional classroom to the CDF committee? Who will be sitting in that classroom? Community. Children of that community. Even though you're running the school yourself. Isn't it? Mm-hmm. If you can change a community from where? In those constituents, isn't it?
Yes.
CDF means constituents development part.
Yes.
Church is development in the constituents. If the church is involved, access the CDF. I have said it. Unfortunately, unfortunately, when the president says it, it means it's police. So, I can go on. Mines, I've talked a lot. We're working on Mopani case here. Copperbelt, like what was said here, that is the only province that carries what we step on, the name. Without the mind functioning properly in the Copperbelt, life cannot function here. But these are inherited problems, but we'll deal with them. Because that's what we elected as a government.
Amen.
Including contracts, suppliers, contractors, including employment. All these are on our list, on our agenda. All of this. Fertilizer. We're talking to a farmer here. This year, fertilizer will be there on time. Last year, we were adjusting from those who were supplying there, but got them paid. A lot of our suppliers got into a habit where they were getting contracts, they get a down payment, they don't supply. Then they go to you and say, I've not been paid. They never supplied any. How can you be paid if you didn't supply any? How can the economy work? Please, when you are given a contract, supply. And then you ask to be paid for what you supply. That's how the economy will work and grow. So, this year, the fertilizer and the fishing will be with the farmers on time. The advert is already out. I'm sure you've seen it. Let us grow more maize to deal with the issues of congestion, NRC, water cut. No one should need a water cut to buy mini meal. No one. As a businessman, I can say to you, if you have demand, you are very lucky. So just produce. Let us produce more mini meal. Feed ourselves, lower the price of mini meal by simply the supply and demand. That's why we're giving millers subsidized meal. But there's dishonesty, my men and women. We give subsidized maize, mill and steel mill, and sell at a higher price. So your message is clear. We'll re-engage them again. We'll be engaging them, we'll re-engage them. So I can go on electricity, fuel, farm, the water price is taken. We'll look into that. So Vanessa Nina Nakari. Harassing citizens, no one should be harassed. Written submissions, lady gave envelopes, look at them. CDM, Inandar Karen, pre-education, deal. I'm happy to know people are not sick. I'm happy to know. Deal allowances, correctional services. How can I forget correctional services? I'm one of the customers there. But I want to say to you, my men and women of God, we will do the best we can to bring back decency in the prisons. God sent me there for this one. It's not those who sent me there who arrested me. No. God sent me there so that I can do what I'm doing now. But the good news you must be happy about is that we have removed, this your government has removed the death sentence. Presidents before me couldn't do it, they were shy, they were scared. We've done it. I was on the death row myself. Treason is a death row. So God put me on the death row, and eventually through you put me in the presidency so that I can remove the death row. You think I'd have been shy to do it when I know I was arrested for a crime I did not commit? And I was going to be hanged until pronounced dead for a crime at the moment. It means there are other people there who did not commit those crimes, but they are on the death row. This is their time. And further, we have commuted all those on death row to life, because there's an instrument we needed to sign. And we have already signed it quite. I don't think most of you know about that. That's what you sent us to do. Then I'm off again. Wow, Gambo, Inandar Kale, Petiko, Inandar Kale, Township Roads, Ndola, everything, Chabeshi, should become a district. This is one of the most common issues everybody on the Copperbelt is thinking about. Chabeshi becoming a district. You have a point. We hear you. We look at it. The important thing is that creating a district means creating a new constituency. To create a new constituency, we need a constitutional amendment. Very sad. Those who framed the constitution in 2016, they messed it up, I'm sorry to say. To create a new constituency, you need a constitutional amendment. But you can't have a district which has no constituency. Have you seen that? Things of the past follow us in the future. But we'll work on it, we'll do our best. But we agree with you. The good thing is that we agree with you that Chamesh should be coming. Yeah. In the meantime, we should do certain administrative things to allow that to happen. Yes. As we wait for the constitutional amendment. Yeah. Land, I started with that. Because I'm in love with land. I'm a child of nature, born in a village, Some say I was born in the cattle town. They will be close to being right. So others must access land. For housing, shelter, for warehouse, for change, for everything. Tomorrow I'm meeting the chiefs of the government, all of them. Tomorrow. That's this government's agenda. Every time I go to a province, we'll meet government issues, projects, everything. We'll meet our party, but more importantly, we'll meet the clergy in every province. Let's please help us to organize that properly. Then we'll also meet traditional leaders and other groups so that we can hear what people are saying, different segments, and work on their consent. But also so that they can advise us where we go wrong. We are human. So please advise us. Total agreement, the railway system. Again, I don't want to announce now, it's too premature. Time will come, we're working on the rail system. Including revamping Tazara, our online is too slow, too run down. No investment over yet. I hope you remember that the first euro bond we borrowed was $750 million was meant for the railroad system. Nothing was invested. Zero. Roses will say, no, no, no. Zero. So but we have to do that, to take the heavy load off the roads. Very important one. This is why I'm impressed with this clergy. They have so much technical understanding. I want to encourage this clergy to develop the skills in our country. I must also dare say it now, because you've heard it. What took me to Angola was many things. A part of it was to revive the Benguela Railway. The Lobito. That's why you hear it. It's okay, tidbit. I talk of Egypt and they're up there. We're working on that. We hope by June or so we will have something to announce to the nation. I think these are the issues you raised. Some we have received it then. But overall, as I close, on behalf of my team, and I believe Elizabeth, to just once more thank you, Bishop Kajira, for hosting us. Again, thank you to the clergy on the Copperbelt. Showing this high level of organization. I think government must borrow the art of good organization from the church. We thank you for your prayers. Before, difficult time during our difficult time. Now, continue praying for us. We also pray for you. We may not be expert as you are, but we also pray for you. I want to say to God, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, our God, to say thank you for everything you have done for the people that are in this nation. You carried us this far, carry us ahead. Why are we told Taylor? Let's have me by. Where is the cabinet? Let's take a shot.
Thank you, sir.
I am a president, Mala, Pitava, to Ballet, Pushak, and 55 years from Maboko. All right. I am to wave our president. Can we wave back to the president? Patatlampai. The president is going around just to say hello to the clergy. Just be where you are. Trying to approach our president. Malakwale la kondusi kwa la yafi straight with people. Inya kusalila the closing prayer. Immediately following that, we'll do the closing prayer. Closing prayer. Bishop Kaweme is ready now to offer the closing prayer.
Thank you. We remain upstanding as we do the closing prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for this important meeting where our Republican president has been.